lyric says, the male component unit is the alleles, and they are more important. I have bought a set of 100 LEDs, five colors. I kept it aside. Now you need some common things, and the main requirement is a geared motor. I have a geared motor here. You must choose the RPM according to how slow you want the LED to light up. So I have taken 1000 RPM over here, 1000 RPMs. I kept this aside. Then you need a CD putting plate, inside which you can pin some common pins like this. I'll show you. A common pin you can find anywhere in a store, a local store. I had a lot of them, so I use this. I use a CD this so that you can get the small hole over here. You can use this. Otherwise, you can take some board like this or something like this. Create a big hole in the middle for the geared motor. Then some small holes in a circle for taking the connections. Now I have made like this. Now I stuck put a hole in the hole and stuck these pins to it. There are 7 pins in mine. And one more thing is that you must put a small hole close to the circle, so that you will get the contact over there. So I'm putting, after putting them, I glued them back part with some cardboard. This side, one pin which is going to the middle must not be glued, because we need the output taken over here. In these, I am connecting it to, the cables are coming from here, so I didn't use that. I use a glue over here. Now just put this back. I just kept that middle one. This should not be glued so that we can take the contact. That's the main thing. So total there are 8 pins in mine, 8 of them. Then you must need some connectors so that you can connect the LED and all. A battery mainly for charging it, for lighting the LED. Then you need some, you can use cables instead of these connectors. I am planning to use coils, so the wire which we use as coil, so that it shall not become visible, so it will be looking clean. Now let's start. Now we must first connect cables to 7 pins outside, in the outside circle, these 7 pins. And one more thing, you must cut the pointed end from the top, because you may get an injury in your hand. We can connect this using a cable. I am using copper coil. Okay, let's connect it. I have the copper coil which I winded to make a transformer. Now I don't need that, so I'm using this coil to connect, take separate connections from each pin. These pins are made of metal, so they are good conductors, so I'm using them. You must connect it. I'll show you how it looks after connection. Now I have stuck the cables. It has been left kept for drying now. I put some normal tape and stuck it using super glue. Kept it for drying. After it dries, we can finish the rest on. I'll tell you an easy method to take the coating out of this cable. The easy method is that you can use the sandpaper. You will get a big piece like this. Cut it into a small piece. Bend it into half. Keep it like this and pull it. Now, when we do like this, most of the coating will get out. Like this, you can make this. Now, after drying, we can fix the geared motor to the sender, and we can also connect one cable to the pin. And one thing is that inside this, I have only connected the cables to 7 pins, that too in the outer circle, and the one which I kept it close to the inner circle, I have left it free. I have not connected any cable or anything to this. This is the main power supply. I'll tell you how this supplies the voltage from this. Now let this thing dry, then we can do the rest. Now take some copper cable. I cleaned it, so the coating is gone from this much length. Now I made it into a thicker size by bending it. Now it cut. After bending it correct in the middle, just cut the rest off. Cut the cable. Only this much cable is with me. I twisted it and kept it. For this, you can use some pens, a refill or something, and twist it easily. I'll tell you how after this dries we can fix this. Now I twisted it. Now again I bend it into half so that it becomes more thicker. But before that, I took the geared motor. There's a hole over here. I just put this through it, and after putting through this, I will bend it. So you will get the close contact of the motors gear. Sorry for interrupting, my father came in. I have connected it like this. Then I will set the size so it's fairly okay. Then I am cutting this edge. First I will round it properly. Then I am cutting the edge using a plier. Now it has been kept right. Now I am thinking of filling this hole, rest of the hole, with something so that it stays in the correct position. Now we can fix this motor. Just put it through the hole. But before that, we must connect one cable to this pin, because this part of the geared motor doesn't have any contact with this part or something, because there are plastic gears inside it. So I am taking this pin. I am using this pin over here so that I can make a contact to this part or something like this by bending it or keeping some other cable over there. now I will fix some cable to this and then push it back through the hole over here. So I took some cable. I had a green cable lying around, so I am going to connect it. After connecting it, I twisted the cable. I took the needle and I fixed it around. After fixing this, I just put this thing back into the hole. Now I have the main cable outside. After this one, let me check whether the glue has dried. Yeah, the glue has dried. Now I'll fix the mortar into this. Then fix it using the bolt given. Just bent it down. One problem came. The problem is that it is the cable, the needle which I kept is being pushed by the gear motor, so I'm placing it again. Taking out again, I fixed it. Okay, this thing I got it correct. As the I took put the needle in the hole for the, there was a small gap left here for the screw, so I use that. Now I am taking a plier and bending this cable and this needle such that it touches. That it okay, now this cable is bent perfectly. So after this we can connect these cables to the breadboard. Before that we must take the cables from the motor also, and then I'm using this thing, using this tapes to keep it properly because the due to the motor's length. After placing this, I don't need this much extension of this cable, so I'm cutting it. I cut the cable. Fixing it to the motor. We can solder this cable, but my father told no need to solder it, so I'm not using the soldering iron. Fixed. After putting some cable for the length, took another one. Just bear turning it and taking through the holes given here. Now two cables are coming out of the motor. I connected one to the I'm thinking I can make the needles the negative part, as it shall be more better. I connected this part also to the negative part of the motor. After connecting this, it and kept like this. So I have finished this much part of it. Now we can connect the cables and the rest of the things. I have kept everything in order so that it shall be easy. Put one each into one hole, that too in the correct order so that shall give the effect. After placing, you can leave a gap between one port, as the LED will take that space. After placing all the cables, after placing these much cables correctly, let's show a closer look. Connected this much. Now I'm going to connect the cables from the motor. Now I'm taking a connector and using one of them as a positive terminal. You can use the side ones as the connection is like this, whereas the other ones are in a horizontal way. I took the positive end and kept it on the other side. Now we can take the LEDs. I'm planning the first. There are 7 of them, so I am planning two yellow. Must connect it in the correct way. Two LED two of them. Two yellow airport. Now I will put green green. And then you can put any color you wish. I'll put it in any. Just simply taking some LEDs. This Android, I don't know which color they will look. Fixing this. Now you should connect a resistor to the LED so that it cannot take direct voltage, as it can only take a few milliamp currents. So I'll take a resistor. I'm taking a 12 volt. This really. A 6 volt 4.5 ampere battery. I've connected two of them together. And now I have the resistor. I'm connecting the resistor to the positive end, and I'm taking this connector from there, connecting it here. After looking this is a question. Now let's check whether it is working. I'll fix a screw to this one, so it shall stay properly. I have connected all the LEDs and all in the correct position. I also glued everything and connected the cable using some pins. I had to bend some pins so that the cable connects it. After connecting this, this will start rotating and hit each of the and go. When I do like this, the cable bends, so I don't do like it. It's not bad. Advice to do like this. After doing like this, spin so fast, and our LED goes like this. So fast, so we can't see anything. When I slow down the screen, you can see almost all the LEDs lighting up. When I stop the screen, doing it is nice. We give you another variation. Some LEDs will light and some will not light. Like that, if we keep on rounding, the same LEDs will not repeat again and again. Because there are some blue something. I'm Anand Jay and I'm signing out. Thanks and bye.